Hello, how are you doing, beautiful people? It is me again. My name is Princess Yanja, your sister at heart, and I am back again, guys, with another Unisa video. So with this video, I am actually going to be talking about the things that are bothering me with Unisa currently. And I'm hoping that there is some other people. Okay, I'm not hoping because it's not a good thing. But I think there are other people out there who are going through the same situations as I'm going. So I decided maybe let me just talk about the problems that I'm facing with Unisa. And some of them I actually am finding solutions for them. Some of them is just a waiting game. At this point with level, I don't even know which level we're in. Last time I checked, we were in level 3. Are we on level 2? I'm not sure. Unisa was closed. As soon as the president announced that on level 2 or 3, Unisa closed, and I was supposed to go back there with what I was working on, because I was working on the same issue of my modules. Some of my modules were having some issues, so I couldn't go back to follow up because they're closed. So I've been checking with Unisa in Durban. I don't know other places, but in Durban specifically, Unisa still remains closed, you know, so it is a problem. So if you are a final year student and your status when you open your academic doesn't show or doesn't specify on the status that you are doing your final year, you have to find out what is the issue. You have to contact Unisa. I'm going to leave all the contact information down below in the description box. The second thing, everybody's going crazy about the monitoring app. I don't know if I'm calling it right. I don't know if that's what they call it. There is an app apparently in Unisa, at Unisa, there is an app that will be watching you while you're writing your exams. If you have not checked your emails and you have examinations which are coming out, actually suggest that you do that right now. I'm actually going to do a screenshot right now that's going to show you how to check if your modules are part of the app, okay? Because then you want to have to familiarize yourself with how it works. There are videos on YouTube as well, which I'm also going to leave a link down below, that actually show you how does it work and what you need to do. Okay, so you want to go to Google and type on My Unisa. You want to log in on My Unisa. Then you're going to have to scroll down below. After logging in, you will see there where it is talking about Invigilation application, the app for Invigilation. You press on it, that's a link. Then it will bring you to this page. There you want to click there where it says click here, where it's blue. After you've done that, it will also bring you to this part. You're gonna scroll down and then they'll show you access the list of invigilated modules. You wanna press that link. It's gonna take you to the link where you can download the document, where it's gonna show you all the modules that are included in this application or in this app. So these are all the lists. This is after I've downloaded, so make sure that you have Microsoft Reader on your phone to be able to read it or use a computer. Thank you.
So that's the story about that app. The third thing that I wanted to talk about, I came across an issue. I want to do honors in psychology as soon as I finish graduating, or as soon as I finish this current degree, of which I'm doing the last year off. And I know there are people who are like me, who are finalizing with their studies, with their degrees and stuff, so they want to continue with their studies and do honors. I was very disappointed when I went to Unisa and I was actually going through the application process, and then Unisa actually sent me a message, you know, that those messages which are like robots messages which just give you a feedback right at the same time, at the spot. So it told me that there has not been any qualification that have been completed under my name that has been detected for me to qualify to apply for honors. And I was confused because I'm applying, I'm not registering for honors, I'm applying so that the time I finish with my degree, I should be able to apply next year, sorry, to register next year, when people who are registering for honors are registering, planning to do honors the following year. So I don't know how it works. Are we supposed to like have to graduate first and the system to recognize that we have completed a degree? Only then we will be able to apply. So I don't understand how it works. And yet the funny part, application dates are currently open for honors. They are allowing us to apply, like the dates are actually saying you can apply for honors, but when you try to apply for honors while you are a degree student who's finishing, it says you don't have a completed, you know, qualification. So I was kind of confused there. So if you are going through the same thing, or if you have any solutions or you know anything, please let us know down below in the comment what's the story. They want us to fully complete our studies before we can actually start applying, meaning that it's going to take a little bit of a delay. you know, but I guess maybe that's how it works. You're just gonna have to wait. Going back to the issue of the final year students who are not having the status showing that they're doing their final year. So this was my case. I'm sharing with you my case because there might be someone out there who's going through the same situation who might not know what to do. On my modules, when I opened my academic record, there were some modules that I have finished, meaning I've written assignments, submitted, passed, and I've written my examinations on them, and I passed because I was sent even results. But then on my academic record, they show no result. They show they just show the name, they show the code, and the status is financial cancellation. So I was confused, what is this financial cancellation? Because I did write the exams, and I was allowed to write exams because I did pass, and I was not owing, meaning that I was even able to get my marks during that time. And this is like, it was long time ago, because I saw one of the modules, is the modules that I did in 2017. The other ones, the two, because there's three of them, the other two, I did them in 2019. So I didn't understand what was the issue there. But then when I did go to Unisa, and I was having a conversation with this lady who was working in the cashier section, she and I actually concluded that maybe the issue was during the time when Unisa was having making mistakes in the system when it was showing you the balance that you were owing. I don't know if you guys remember this. If you've been with Unisa for some time, there was a time with Unisa where they would show a wrong balance that is all that you need to pay on the fund under your financial details. So when they show a wrong balance, if they show a less balance than the actual amount, which is might be more, you pay that money which is less, and then it will update later on, and then it will be as if you paid less, but when it was showing less money, and that is their fault. I shouldn't have to suffer for this. Like, honestly, it is not fair. I don't want to lie to you. So that was the case. So my modules are actually showing financial cancellation. So what she told me that I need to pay 3,000 rand. I said, like, what now? 3,000 rand for what? But because I want to finish studying, guys, I'm not going to have questions. I'm just going to do what she tells me, and I did. Okay, she told me that I need to put 3,000 rand according to what she was seeing on the system. She will then send an email to Pretoria to specify that the money that I'm paying is like 3,000 rand is actually for these financial cancellation modules to be released, to be paid, and to show on the system. Then I was supposed to come back to her to hear the feedback. How did it go? That is when our president decided to announce that we're going on level 3 again, and I couldn't go back because when I did go back, Unisa was closed. They were not working. Okay, so that is the issue. Those are the issues that we are having with Unisa. So if you have something that is similar to my situation and you see that your modules are written financial cancellation, it might be the fact that when the Unisa was updating their financial details on their system, they might have shown a wrong amount. And it happened quite a number of times before. I remember very well, it was a long time ago, but it was happening a lot. They could show the wrong amount of money, so we pay that amount of money, but then, you know, only to find that it is not the actual amount of money that you were supposed to pay. So as a result, some of the modules will be showing as financial cancellation. So it actually made sense to me as a final year student, why my status doesn't show that I'm doing my last year. I did actually call them yesterday, and the guy that I did find, he also noticed that I did change my names, of which was true. I did change my names early this year. And then he was telling me over the phone that it shows that you change your names, but even that process is even not done on their system. I was like really frustrated by that, but I was calm. Okay, so it is very important when you do something with Unisa, keep on checking out how it is going. So the biggest question I've been asking myself of late is, am I really interested into doing my honors with Unisa? And to be honest with you, that's a very big question right now that I have that I need to answer. Because at this point, to be honest with you, what I really feel will make me stay with Unisa is because their fees are reasonable. And they're reasonable for a reason, because
there's not much that is happening compared to the universities where the students are actually attending and full time. They have full time lecturers and stuff. So for us, most of the things we have to do it ourselves. It's like self-serving and self-service most of the time, you know. So like for an example, this year most of us never received our study material. And I understand there's COVID and everything is changing, but it doesn't show that there have been some things that are being done. You know, we've never even got messages apologizing that they are sorry that they never sent us, you know. So luckily things are online, and they have been urging us over the years that we must rely online mostly more than any other things, more than any other way of doing things. So luckily they do make sure that the study materials are online, so you just have to print them out with your own cost, with your own expense, with your own money. You print them out and make sure that you have them so that you'll be able to continue and further your studies. Otherwise, if you wait on them, nothing is gonna work out for you. So it's a big question right now. I don't know, maybe when we do another video, I'll be able to actually give you an answer if I'm really coming back to Unisa or not. Right now, me wanting to do my honors, I truly want to do my honors. I want to continue with my studies, but I'm just having, you know, doubts now with going back to Unisa. Many of the other things, they change our modules during while we are still doing the degrees. They change our modules, the modules which were semester modules, they change to year modules. So it's been a lot, guys. We traumatized as Unisa students. We need counseling. But we're pushing because we want what we want, so we're pushing. As a result, I'm doing my final year. So the fact that I'm doing my final year is just crazy for me. If I can do it, you can do it as well. I don't know what year you're doing, but if you're with Unisa, bear with Unisa and make sure that you check your emails all the time. Log in on my Unisa all the time. Also, they always leave the announcements at the homepage. There are links down there. When you look, they will always tell you the things which are new and upcoming. So always stay up to date at all times, guys, what's happening. Otherwise, you will fall back and you'll find yourself delayed and it will be very frustrating. So you don't want to do that, guys. So thank you so much for staying tuned in. My name is Princess Yanja. If you have not subscribed, please do press the subscribe button so that you can be able to see my videos every time when I upload. Stay blessed.